I don't think he's got any ambitions of joining, you know, the rally side of the team, but this one's going to be exciting. Yeah. Liam Doran, the British bomber. Ollie Eriksson has the inside line. Eriksson's got a much better launch than Doran. Doran goes backwards. He's going to go straight into tactics mode. Liam's got great exit speed here. He's in the tail of Ollie Eriksson, but there is no way through, and squashes the jump. Eriksson flies really long.
Yeah, Ollie Eriksson going really long, as you say. Similar to that of Tandem Battle. Look at Liam Doran, slides it in. Tandem battle. Look at this. They push back and forth. We got a boxing match between Doran and Eriksson.
Great pass by Doran there. He had that backed in from a long way back. He knew he was going to go for the undercut door to door. There's nothing wrong with that contact. Great move, Jared. Really muscled his way through.
Just the way Doran is moving that car around. He's just got more angle. He's coming in backwards. A gravel machine gun as Doran is trying to get and maintain that clean air. Here comes Eriksson. Does he take the Joker lap?
100%.
Or is he keep applying the pressure?
He's going to go Joker. I thought Doran was going to cover him off there. And Eriksson, I think, maybe thought the same. Two inputs on the steering. And it wasn't a great Joker. So that's advantage Liam. But I reckon Liam will go on the next lap. Because to me, Ollie looked quick on that first lap.
3.3 second difference here on the splits. Doran out front. Doran is looking just aggressive. Like you said, he loves the track. He does big sends. Look at that massive backwards entry. What is going on?
That's Liam all over that. He said to me this morning, I came up here, he said, I braked, put it in the wall. And then Andrea was like, what did he like? He said, yeah, but I like it. I wanted to send it. And then he said, I know what I need to do. I need to send it in earlier. We need to get on it, get it rotated, and get on the gas. So that's what he's doing. At the minute, the gap is 3.3, but it's tight. I wonder if he's going to wait one more lap. I'm not convinced that the showboating's faster.
Right, and Eriksson, you saw him just temper the flame, dialed it down. Look at Liam Doran, where's he going? Looks like
he's got Joker.
Joker. Liam with that Joker lap. And how does he come out? Door to door, Doran just edges him out and holds on to that lead.
Wow, that was close. He lost a 10th, Jared, in the previous sector. He lost a 10th to Ollie, and I thought he was going to be closer than that, but great driving by both of them to keep out of each other. And Liam now's just got to keep the door shut. So will he go quite a showboater? Yes,
he will.
Because he's Liam Doran. Get in. Look at that. You see the inside left lip in the roost up as well. Full throttle, full send. Get in, Liam.
I mean, this is looking more Formula Drift than it is Nitro Rallycross right now with those entries. But Doran is doing it his way, right?
Liam has got the most incredible car control. So the likes of Petter Solberg, I would put him up there with that kind of car control. Jared, he was at Loeac, a French circuit, and we had Vaughan Gittin Jr. was there. Liam just jumped in a drift car with Vaughan and went out like he was a pro. Oh, Ollie Eriksson looking up the inside line. Liam needs to not lose out. That's going to be a run to the line. Ollie tries the move. Liam sideways. Ollie, if he'd waited there, might have got it, but it does go the way of the British bomb.
So Liam Doran shuts the door on Ollie Eriksson, and that was a great battle. Wow.
That might be my favorite battle so far.
For sure.
You know? The one, certainly here, the ones last weekend, the crowd like it as well. Everyone's on their feet here applauding, and it's gonna be Doran versus Speed.
Wow, that should be fun.
It will.
Man. So Doran and Speed, so our great eight is shaped up. let's take a look at it again. That was an absolute battle of the ages.
Amazing. So Liam, look at this, with a great exit from turn one over the jump. Ollie flies super long. The car now, he does get it settled. Look, he's got it on the brakes, but he's slightly deep. Doran sets it up really early, which is what he did on all the following laps. He's got the inside line. There's nothing wrong with that. That is a great rallycross pass. You won't see many passes better than that.
Dude, the British bomb absolutely lit the fuse and blew it up here at ERX. Airing it out. Eriksson went really long, and look at that thing slammed down. I'm surprised it kept going, and we saw that from Tanner Faust earlier. He had to retire. We've seen everybody on turn one, and then going into two, everybody's just airing it out.
Liam, look, keeping the distance short over that top jump, just landing just off the knuckle. That's what Scott had said was the right way to do it. Look at, again, that difference. Look at Tanner. When we saw Tanner, it was just a tiny bit quicker than Kevin Hansen had gone here. We're seeing Kevin Eriksson just a little bit quicker than Liam. But the difference in trajectory and, like, flight length is insane for 5 miles an hour.
Yeah, I mean, we need air traffic control out here with the way, I mean, that's our motto, right? Cars that fly. And they are living up to it. And you asked the right question there when Travis was in here. He said, what can we expect for future rounds? said he's got two over-unders in Arizona.
Yeah, I believed it was Gap, but maybe it's Bridge, not sure. But you never know what to expect, and right. I love that. I'm loving the track so far. You know, there's loads to learn. Everybody knows that. Everybody's working super hard here at Nitro Rallycross to make sure everything's great. There have been some changes from last week to this week. Little tweaks on the regulations. You know what? This didn't work. Let's change it up. We'll make it work better. Everybody here is working so hard behind the scenes to make sure you guys have the best show, whether you're here watching trackside or whether you're watching at home. So give us everybody a chance. You know, look at Yokohama today working on the tires. Yep. Look at the track guys working on the track after heavy rain. People are working hard. I hope you're enjoying it.
That's right. I think they are. And that right there, Eriksson almost got Doran. You saw him throw it out wide and it looked like he gripped up, but then Eriksson just couldn't get it done. So there.